everybody, and welcome to this tutorial. Today I am gonna finish up with this section. I will show you how you can actually monitor all traffic that goes on the network, the clone network that you have set up on your laptop or desktop or whatever. Anyway, why is this important? Well, first of all, don't get your hopes up too high, because you won't be able to actually get passwords or user credentials by just listening to traffic. You can if they're not using any encrypted protocols, but if they're using HTTPS, I can forget about it there. That's going to be too difficult. I mean, there are some methods that are experimental today, but I haven't really included them here as they are still experimental. If you just go back a tutorial or two, you have an option of SSL strip, so you will be able to rid yourself of that encryption and read the credentials in clear text without any problems of whatsoever. Now, it doesn't, maybe not, it doesn't always work with all browsers and all websites, but like 90% of the time it will work without any bigger problems. Now, why then, you might ask yourselves, why would we do this? Well, you are able to see who is browsing what sort of content. You're able to see who is logging into the backends of the web servers. You're able to see if somebody's using official email or any email for that matter. And you are able to see who is using which type of services on the net. And in such a way, you will be able to pick your target in a relatively easy fashion. You will see who has what. Okay, I need this, so let's go for it. Anyway, this is not the only reason why we have access to, why we have created an evil twin. We want it for, we can use it for other purposes, such as a DNS change of the DNS servers and the router. And as I've stated previously, that's going to enable us to do some wonderful social engineering, whereby we will be able to take usernames, passwords, user credentials in general without any bigger difficulties. But for the time being, let's just see how is traffic actually analyzed. Let me just go ahead and clear the screen here. Zoom it in, move it here. For this purpose, we will of course need a tool with which we can actually listen to traffic, and that tool is called Wireshark. That's one of many. There are others out there. Wireshark is the most used one. I would definitely recommend it, but if you don't feel like it, just go on the net and see what else is out there. Now, it's pretty simple to, it comes with a pretty simple installation method, so yum search Wireshark. And it should pop up here somewhere. You need to install two packages. It will enable you to listen to pretty much all traffic that goes through your network without any problems. However, as I said before, you won't be able to take passwords from encrypted traffic. Moreover, Wireshark is, I mean, that's a course for itself, and it's rather lengthy. There are a lot of options. It's a pretty sophisticated tool. I won't go through all of the options today, but I will show you some of the basics and how you can actually monitor traffic based upon the information that I give you. So you will need this package here that I'm selecting, and you will need the bottom one. Hopefully by now you know how to install. It's yum space install space the name of the package space dash y, so you wouldn't be prompted for any questions, and it will install it without any problems. Now I have Wireshark running here somewhere. Yep, there we go. Now I have opened it, and here you can take a pick from the list of interfaces on which you wish to listen. Our interface is of course evil, and that is what we want to listen to all the traffic that goes on it. Now there isn't much traffic here, primarily because there isn't much that is going on, but you can see immediately there are some basic packets that are going through. And let me just see if I can browse something on my phone or something of a kind. This is just router communication. So let's go over to Firefox over here. I'm just literally opening up a website on my phone, and that is it. You can see that immediately the amount of traffic is jumping insanely. Look at how much of it there is. So all this traffic is generated basically, well, most of this traffic is generated by one single device. And I'm gonna go ahead and stop the capture here because I am no longer interested in this. Over here you can see the queries, and here you can actually see the URL from time to time. The URL is a small piece of all of this, but not sure if I can find it now as there is a lot of it. Look, here's one. It says standard query response safebrowsing.cache.l.google.com. You can see the IP address that was accessed from which the response, I do believe this is from which the response came. Anyway, again, we have something related to Google. I don't have a browser open. There is literally no traffic going on my network here. However, there is traffic that is being generated from my phone. There we go. And this is like www.google.ba. That is this. You see here, you have the URL here that is being accessed, and you can see that has been requested here. If I just double click on it, if I open it, I'm gonna get a listing of pretty detailed information here. So domain name, if I just click on it, there's some sort of information here, not very useful to you at the time, but you can just go down to queries and you can see the URL. That is probably the most important thing for you in this particular, at this particular point in time. This is how you can actually see who is browsing for what, who wants what, who is going where. Not a bad idea, pretty good thing to do, especially because you can, as I said before, you can actually pick the targets and you can see their IP ad, you can see the IP addresses here. I mean, you can see which IP address has requested which site. So this first colon that you are looking at now, where it says source, so source IP addresses, and then you have next one is destination IP addresses. I'm clicking on the two of them. So if you take a look at the top right quarter, it says 192, the gray one, it says 192.168.1.101, and then there is destination, which is 173.194.116.225. So the IP ad, the device with this first IP address, 192.168.1.101, has requested something from the destination IP address of 173.194.116.225. There was a communication in between these two IP addresses. Now that can be different sorts of traffic, and for the time being you can disregard most of this. What you are interested in are those URLs to see what sort of information are people browsing, and you can see and get the addresses. For example, if they're logging into their company servers that have an external IP address, you can actually see it here in the destination IP addresses part. And in such a way, you can go ahead, try to open it up in your browser and see what sort of login procedures does it actually require, how hard is it, is it HTTP or is it HTTPS. It can give you a lot of information. Now this is just a raw overview of data. I encourage you to expand upon this subject further. In the upper left corner there are filters, and here you can type in various values to try to pick apart the information. For example, I can type in DNS. So give me all the DNS queries, and it's gonna give me all the DNS queries that have been made, which is very nice because I now know what my phone has requested. So look, it has CCNA, that's for Cisco. It has requested Google. It has pulled some, is this an image from YouTube? I have no idea what this is. I don't know. In any case, it has contacted YouTube. Again, it went over to Google, and yeah, there you go. There's safe browsing, Google clients, Google, yeah. Okay, so I have opened up Firefox. I've seen something on Google. I obviously can't see the search results, but I can see when a person clicks on one of those search results and requests that particular URL. For that purpose, DNS filter is your friend, but doesn't necessarily need to be. You can just leave it empty and see how it goes. You can also type in ip.addr space equals equals, and then you can type in the IP address here, for example 192.168.1.101. Excellent. So now we have all the traffic which has either a source or a destination IP address of 192.168.1.101. So if you wish to see traffic of a particular IP address, you can use the filter that I have just used. I would strongly encourage you to expand upon this subject further. There is a course on Udemy that I have made as well, but you don't have to go there. I mean, you also obviously have a great deal of knowledge on the internet as well, so you can explore it there, because Wireshark and network traffic monitoring is a subject of its own. That's like a course of its own. There's a huge amount of information. But you are able to get the basic information which interests you at this point of time. In any case, I am going to wrap the tutorial up here, and in the next chapter, we're going to get into routers and how to break the first line of defense for pretty much any major network out there. Until then, I bid you farewell, and I hope to see you in the next tutorial.